now I will present the instrument that is now designed, produced, calibrated and tested for Mikhail Lomonosov mission. I think that everybody knows about this mission and about the payloads that are now prepared for the radio studies for Mikhail Lomonosov satellite. And I will make some detailed report about the instrument BDRG, that means boxes of detectors for gamma ray and X-rays. So maybe I will not speak about detailed scientific and theoretical maybe models, but more detail will be about the instrument calibration and the data structure coming from this instrument. And some words I will say about trigger of gamma ray doses and the accuracy of the net estimator that will come from this instrument. It is in some way we can call it some classic instrument for gamma ray burst triggering, and it is the set of three gamma ray detectors directed in Cartesian system. Their axes are about 90 degrees from each other, and by comparison of readings of these three detectors, we can estimate the position of gamma ray burst. We will make trigger working in classical energy range from 10 dB up to 3 dB. But for trigger we'll use energy range from 20 to 100 dB. These are parameters of mission, and the important thing is data amount of mission, about 3 gigabytes per day. And of course, this will be not data from gamma ray detectors in this where most of them will be data from wide field optical cameras, similar to the Master Robotic Telescope. And we have a complex of instruments for GRB study on board Lomonosov with LG. This is gamma spectrometer that I will present. But you know, sure, it is wide field optical camera that was discussed in the previous report, and before maybe in the next report. In details. Some important words about the method. We want to study from the mission, and if we will rotate all spacecraft, we will lose time. So there are two ways to make measurements in multi-wavelengths of prompt emission. First method is not to point our instrument but have a wide field of view and to fix data that are coming when to the field of view of optical camera when the trigger occurs. Other method is not to rotate all spacecraft but maybe some wide part of the instrument, some mirror, and to point with very fast time. So this kind of equipment will realize all two methods. So the estimations are that gamma ray bursts will be occurring in gamma ray detector about one burst per day. maybe one first or 2 days. It depends not only of wide field of view, but also some limits will put for the parameter, because mission will have low orbit and some regions of trapped radiation will be sometimes fast, so we will have maybe about 1/2 the time suitable for gamma ray burst detection on the with nice sensitivity. We estimate that about one burst per month maybe will come to the field of view of optical cameras. This is a photo of three detector box of PDRG instrument. They use saturation detectors with complex detectors. I will show on the next slide. They have the diameter about 13 centimeters each and thickness about 2 centimeters, so they are optimized for the work in the NG range for gamma ray burst detections. Then here are the parameters of the detector box. Mass about 5.5 kilograms for each side detector box. Our conception really it is 2.5 watts. And data from three detector boxes will be collected by one information box that contain processors that will make everything about data frame forming and about triggering for gamma ray burst. So this is information box with about 12 watts power consumption. There are two sets of processors and they make everything for data processing on board. We estimate sensitivity for gamma ray burst about 10 in minus 8 per centimeter square centimeter and GRB location about 2 degrees for bright GRBs. I will show the results of jump modeling that show what brightness of bursts this value will be this one. Of course, this value depends not only of GRB brightness, but also it depends on background conditions, and this depends on the next slide shows the arrangement of each BDRG detector box. We use complex scintillator detector with thin 3 mm layer of sodium iodide and 17 millimeters thickness of cesium in iodide. We use sodium iodide in detector for GRB detection in range about several tens of keV. And in this energies, thick detector is active shield. And when we measure spectra with higher energies, of course, the efficiency of 3 mm detector is low, and most of the radiation will be detected in peak, considerably peak season iodide. We use postage method, that means that we use one foot multiplier to look through these interledgers, and then we determine the place of interaction comparing and analyze the pulse shape. Really, electronics use active collection of the signal in the first part of the pulse from PNP, so-called fast component, and the last part is so-called slow component. The electronic of the DFG detector box contain logics, switch, electronic switch that changes components, and ADCs that make parallel port coming through analysis box. And as to what is inside, some boxes. Really, when the devices were produced, we make some boxes, so you see electronic for voltage converters, electronic for analog analysis, and this is two sets of processors in the analysis box. It is important thing to understand how can we calibrate voltage detector, because we really have complex events, and when the event happens in different scintillators, then it has different varieties of light flash when the gamma ray is detected. So when we plot fast component, so first part, fast part of PMT pulse, and a slow component to two-dimensional diagram, then we see several parts of the diagram. This one is for sodium iodide events, this one is for cesium iodide events, and some intermediate events when some energy released was some energy was released in sodium iodide and other was in cesium iodide, new Compton scaling. This diagram is for cesium 137 well known calibration tools. We use a set of isotopes to calibrate with the energy detector boxes. And of course, from SOC to some background lines, we see K40, a well known element, and gallium 208, maybe 2.6 milli background line from thorium signal SOC. This is the beginning, so we must, during calibration, we estimate where is zero point. We really shifted from 0,0 by electronics. And here you see 32 kV X-ray from signal 137. We see 32 kV X-ray line, and here we see the threshold for energy
starting energy, and as well as for determination of what kind of scintillation the interaction happened, is less than 10 kV. Here you see the diagram in another form. It is angle and it is distance from zero point. So really the energy measure is projection on this axis. It is distance from zero point. And here we see all lines from cesium 137 in this diagram. So calibration, when we make it, is to determine scale separately for sodium iodide, separately for cesium iodide. And here are several sets of straight lines for three BDRG boxes, and also here are two modes, main mode and redundant mode. In each BDRG box there are two sets of power suppliers, main set and redundant set, and really we put different voltage for reliability. For redundant mode it is some less. So there are several different sets. Energy resolution of BDRG box is about 10% for 1 MeV. We expect that it may be some better, but there are some factors making energy resolution worse connected with geometry of the detector. Because when we have very thin and detector with large diameter, the light collection is some worse, and non-uniformity of PMT surface sensitivity must be also taken into account. But the instrument is not in general spectrometric, and 10% maybe it is enough for analysis. It is characteristics of real instrument. Some tests made 2 weeks ago in Istra, we compare the calibration sets. Now for monitoring mode we use such energy interval 10 to 20, 20 to 35, and so on and so on, for sodium iodide and for cesium iodide events. And each second we will transmit to the Earth the data of being a number of events in these intervals. And here are the plots of background for comparison of two BDRG boxes. We see the difference is about maybe 10%. It is some reality, and it shows the accuracy of our calibration. Maybe we must tune, we may tune some better, but 10% I think it is enough. Really, because we have digital thresholds, then we have a set of commands that can come from the ground for changing calibration during the experiment. If some year pass and something changes, we hope that we will see K40 line from satellite data. And if we want to change some threshold, we simply put some command and have new value of threshold.
You can change the threshold, or you can change the gain?
No, we have no analog, maybe chips for tuning in analog form. So if maybe something happens with maybe PMT or the, and the value of signal drops, then we cannot put high voltage or something else or higher amplification. But really, what is important? It is very important for GRB detection and coordinate estimation that we have the same threshold for three boxes. Because if it is not so, then we will have systematic error in coordinates. So for this purpose, it is It depends on. Yes, I analyzed temperature dependence of scintillator in chamber. Yes, of course, cesium iodide and sodium iodide have some dependence on temperature. But it is not so big, maybe, and we hope that it is the same for three boxes. So thresholds will change, but synchronously. So the ratio of rates from gamma burst will be will remain the same. So next one. About GRB trigger and the function of total complex. Here I show simplified field of view. There are three boxes of BDRG. They have about cosine diagram. So this is 60 degrees circles. Total field of view, of course, is about 90 degrees, but this is half wide. And here are simplified field of view of shock. So we have several triggering modes. One mode is that shock is fixing data from corresponding BDRG. And other mode is that shock is fixing data from any BDRG. Maybe third mode is that shock is fixing data when the estimated position is inside. Of course, we are limited in data amount coming from satellite to ground. And really, we can transfer to Earth about two or three bursts per day. And if the threshold will be not good, it will be low, then we will lose data and maybe we will lose some real bursts. So there are several modes, and main mode is that one shock for one BDRG. We will have several levels of triggering. First, the lowest level will be for fixing only gamma ray data. The amount of this data are not so big, so we can transfer to Earth maybe several tens of bursts of different nature in gamma rays. Really, we understand that there are many false bursts that are similar to real, but produced by some particles in the regions of trapped radiation. So really, for alerts, we will have some higher level of triggering. Here is the situation on low orbit. In this plot, it is some bright solar flare. And these are data from CoronaSEF satellite, from some X-ray instrument that contain gamma ray detector, X-ray detector, and anti-quintessence shield that is measuring particles. And here we see some synchronous change of radian with particles. And when we have gamma ray event, it is it has some other ratio. And of course, if we have no comparison with particle detectors, we will see triggers from each of these regions. So we must determine where is it some real gamma ray events or not. First way is to have particle detectors, but also we have internal criterion in BDRG box itself. So when we see real gamma ray burst, it comes from above, and we expect that the readings in sodium iodide soft channel will be more than in soft energy channel of cesium iodide that is active chilled. When we have event connected with particles that are coming from everywhere, then we will have other ratio of rates from sodium iodide and cesium iodide. So in this plot, you can see the result of Jeant modeling. It is the ratio of energy channels for cesium iodide and sodium iodide in different energy. And we see when we have electrons and gamma ray events, we have some difference. Each point is some result of modeling of gamma ray burst with a different hardness. So in the very wide range, we can make good distinguishing between the events, especially for bright bursts, because of course we must make some statistical estimation for bursts with low intensity. We will have triggering for several time scales. Really, we will use three time scales functioning independently. That fastest one is the analysis time interval about 20 milliseconds. And for 100 milliseconds history for analysis of the standard deviation of readings and so on. Other time interval, 1 second for analysis, is best for short gamma ray bursts, and 20-second interval is good for long gamma ray bursts. The criterion is complicated, so we have a number of parameters that can be tuned by comets from the ground. Because we really don't know the background situation, and maybe some criterion parameters, such as the ratio for electron gamma event determination, of course, will be maybe corrected during the first weeks of the experiment. Estimation of GRB position. Classical situation, cosine diagrams of each BDRG box, and we have simple formula that making the estimated angle between the axis of box and the direction of gamma ray bursts. Jeant modeling shows some small correction of diagram of BDRG box that must be taken into account, because we must for different hardness of gamma ray burst, we must understand that the finite efficiency for different energy intervals must be taken into account. So we use some correction for cosine diagram for more accuracy. Really, you see on this plot the dependent of accuracy of GRB position estimation for different background. Here is the best situation where we can say that we have no background. There are some readings about 100 events per second, about 500 events per second. And we see that in the central region, we have maybe about 2 degrees, and it becomes some worse for the peripheral. Next slide will be maybe more understandable. It is background rate in Hertz, and we expect background in equatorial region maybe about 100, maybe about 50 in the energy range that is used for GRB detection. For fluence about 1.10 in minus 6, we have about 2 degrees for different hardness of the bursts. For 10 in minus 5th, it is much better. So it is a situation that we expect. So really, we will have about 2 degrees accuracy. Then some words about data structure. We have continuous data, total about 35 megabytes per day from this instrument, and there are several kinds of data. It is 1 second monitoring in 8 channel for cesium iodide, 8 channel for sodium iodide. There are spectra, 700 channel spectra that will be measured every minute. And then we have so-called two-dimension diagram frame, but really it will be maybe better to call it event mode. So really we have the mode that for some number of events we transfer individually fast and slow components, and we can check calibration. We can in some way make more accurate analysis that this event is caused by electrons or gammas, or maybe when we pass proton belt it will be something else. So it is for detail analysis. We limit the amount of data. So we limit the amount of events, number of events. When the instrument is on equatorial region, we have maybe 3 seconds of data. When we pass region of trapped radiation, we will see maybe part of second of data, but it is not important for us. No, it is only for some analysis, maybe for in-flight calibration and so on. When we have trigger, some detailed information will come in gamma ray. We will have some prehistory because we will have some memory in box of analysis, and some data about seconds before the burst are recorded and are transferred to the Earth. Then we have 1 millisecond for first bursts and 10 milliseconds for maybe 1 second bursts, time resolution and monitoring channels for prehistory and for next time when the burst is analyzed. Then we have spectra and have the same event mode. So really for the burst we will have, for the maximum of each burst, we will have 1 millisecond time resolution. all these data frames and all triggers for fast and slow bursts are formed independently. So if we have slow gamma ray burst, slow gamma ray event, and in the maybe fall of these events something happens with very fast timing, then fast burst mode is activated and we will have data with good time resolution. Total amount is of gamma ray data are 2 megabytes per one burst. This data will be transferred, I think, to the ground burst data together with telegram via global star modem. Together with trigger telegram, with estimation of coordinates, some portion of gamma ray data will come to estimate what is. There are some calibration plots of these two, these three kinds of data. Mm-hmm. So it is a result of ground tests with really ready equipment. And also this is comparison of main redundant mode and so on. We see that the calibration are in 10% show that background readings are the same, with some changes in the lowest channel and the highest channel, maybe because of some real tuning of analog electronics. But these channels are not used for GRB analysis. This is a test plot that shows how the thresholds can be changed by comet. It is the result of ground tests. And the last point shows the triggering situation. It is 2.5 date measurements on ground, only background. When we see the distribution in significance of gamma ray bursts, there are not real, of course, there are some background events. And analyzing this distribution, we can choose the level of significance that is suitable for us. For fast burst, we try to catch about maybe 10, maybe 20 per day. So the level is about 10 standard deviations. For 1 second bursts, the significant level is, of course, less, maybe about 5.5 sigma, maybe. And this is an example of time sequence obtained in on-ground test with americium gamma ray source. And here is some background. Then we place it isotope, and we see the change in readings. And here we see that there is some prehistory. Then after burst modeling appeared some data with 10 millisecond resolution, then some data with 100 millisecond resolution continue, and they will continue, continue, and so on. It is the result shown that our instrument is ready to obtain gamma ray burst. The next step for tests is the attempt to understand the situation with coordinates, but really, it is not a simple way. We now work with pulse generation, with electronics, but really we must put isotope very far to check 2 degrees accuracy. So here's everything that I want to tell.